Happy birthday to me, happy birthday to me, happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to me. Yes, indeed, I am grateful to God for another year that He has added to my life on planet Earth. Today is my birthday and I am here to appreciate God for what He has done, for what He is doing, and for what He is yet to do in my life. I do not take His mercy, His grace for granted, because many of my age mates have died. Many people younger or older than me have died. And so if I'm alive up till this day, it is cause for me to thank God. And so I figured out that in order to thank God, in order to appreciate God, it will be good to share my little story, to share my small testimony with regards to how far God has taken me. It is true that many people started Meaningful 5 Minutes with Mommy Reads with us from the beginning, but some other people met us along the way, and others will eventually meet us along the way. And so on this special day that I'm celebrating my birthday, I'll bring you in with respect to how Meaningful 5 Minutes came about, some of the challenges and some of the ways that we overcame, so that you, that brother or that sister out there with your own divine assignment, can learn a thing or two and get busy in kingdom service. And so you'll be asking me, who is Mommy Reads? Mommy Reads is an African-born but European-based daughter, biological big sister to 4 sisters. She's a wife. She's a mother to 3 biological children for now. Mommy Reads is a trained and experienced conference interpreter. She's a guidance counselor. She's a conference organizer, an events planner. She is a preacher of the gospel. She's an encouragement vlogger. She's a niece to many uncles and aunties. She's an in-law to many. She's, in fact, a child of God. And most of all, she is a sister next door. Yes, Mommy Reads is that sister next door. And so you discover from who Mommy Reads is that you too can get busy in kingdom service, because there is nothing extraordinary about Mommy Reads. She's just that sister next door. And so you, that sister or that brother next door, can also get busy, can also get active in kingdom service. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And the next question will be, how can Mommy Reads describe herself in a few words? Mommy Reads is somebody who is discreet. She doesn't like to talk much about herself. Mommy Reads is down to earth. She's easygoing. She's a fun-loving person. She's God-fearing. And above all, she doesn't like to be taken for granted. Mommy Reads is one person who has as major weakness a difficulty of letting go easily. But by the grace of God, Mommy Reads is moving from grace to grace, and she's able to let go at higher speed now than she was before. You know, most times when they tell us to introduce or present or say something about ourselves, we always say the good things and forget about the weaknesses, forgetting that these weaknesses are there to make us remember that we are only human. God doesn't call the perfect. He calls the imperfect to perfect them along the way. And so if Mommy Reads with her weaknesses is doing the little that she's doing for kingdom advancement, you too, regardless of how big or small your weaknesses are, can get busy, can do something for kingdom advancement. And now the next question will be to say how Mommy Reads identified her call in ministry. You know, most people say ministry, but I prefer to say service, because no matter how we see it, we are servants of God in active service. And so we should be the kind of people who remember that in service, we are entitled, or we are assigned, or we are called upon to do the things that the Master has committed into our hands. There are many ways that people can identify their call in ministry or in service. But in Mommy Reed's case, it was on board a long haul flight that's from Africa to Cameroon. But before we get there, it will be good to say how Mommy Reads gave her life to Christ. Mommy Reads has been in church before, but then there was no encounter with Christ. It was in April 2012. As a result of a difficult pregnancy, it was a matter of life and death that Mommy Reads gave her life to Christ. And from there, she moved from a servant from the intercession to the interpretation to the Sunday school to all the ministries where they were, or to all the departments where there were vacancies. And then eventually the call of God upon Mommy Ritz came in September 2017, on board a long-haul flight, Ethiopian Airlines, from Africa to Europe. And God said, I'll make you minister in the country where you are going to. And it was at night and everybody was sleeping, so you cannot possibly say it was a voice or the voice of man. Everybody was asleep. And so I did not understand, and I began to ask God questions the same way that Mary asked her questions to the angel in Luke chapter 1. And then when we eventually got to the destination, God began to make the vision clear through dreams, through Bible passages, through instructions. The things we say on Meaningful 5 Minutes, the Bible is the road, Jesus the code, seeing the obstacle and heaven the destination, it came in the form of a vision. And God gave the clear instruction with respect to the name of the channel, the fact that it had to be on YouTube. And God also showed us people organizing conferences and told us what he wanted us to do as far as getting women, especially, into kingdom service. And so that is how Mommy Ritz got to identify her call in ministry or in service. Maybe in your own case, God is speaking to you through dreams, through prophecies, through visions, or maybe you identify the need that you can meet, or you derive pleasure in doing that thing, even if you are appreciated or not. Or maybe you have the means to provide for that situation, or maybe the word of God has come through you, come through somebody. You are good at doing this, you are good at doing that. That might just be the way to identify the call of God upon your life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And so what are some of the challenges that Mommy Ritz has encountered along the way, and how has she overcome these challenges? Of course, the first is the fact that there was doubt, because this is not something that has happened before. Yes, we have been in service, kingdom service, but then we needed to be sure that this was the voice of God and not the voice of man. And then God, in his infinite mercy, when we come to him with doubt, he will always give us a way out. Also, insufficient technological knowledge. Mommy Ritz is not a technologically savvy person. She knows the basics of technology. And so the big question was, how was I going to find myself on YouTube? I had been an observer on YouTube, just watching videos randomly. But how to create a YouTube channel is what I didn't know. But God being God, did what he did. He sent a technician in the person of my sister from Germany, who came and gave us a helping hand to kickstart the YouTube channel that you see today. Also, there was serious opposition from the church, from the people around me, from my immediate circle. You know, at the time when God gave me the vision, or God gave me the instruction, nobody in my immediate circle had a YouTube channel. And so it was a novelty, and people were wondering, how is it going to be? What, and more to that, Mommy Ritz does not have any title attached to her name. And so some people were wondering, why you of all people with no title? And then at that time, many women were not in ministry, many women were not preaching, many women were not, you know, doing the things that they are doing now. And so it was kind of a tussle. Why are you doing what you're doing as a woman and somebody with no title, and this and that? And but to the glory of God, he did what he did, and we are where we are today. Also, the opposition was from within myself. Of course, there were things, God had to take me through a training process to be able to teach me how to tolerate people more, to let go faster, to forgive easily, and also to be able to have a feel of what Jesus went through just to get you and I where we are today. And so definitely the way we overcame, I took all my questions to God in prayer. I had to ask God and not man, because the arm of flesh is bound to fail. I already said that he sent a technician from Germany in the person of my sister. Of course, the church is not a gathering of perfect people. It's the gathering of imperfect people who need a savior, or who have been saved by the same savior. God had to make me to understand that. God had to make me to depend on him more, to trust him more, so that I will be considered, or I will be able to see that it is a privilege to serve in the vineyard of God. And so maybe you have also received the call of God upon your life, and you are facing challenges, you're facing opposition. Many people are not understanding the vision. They are trying to water it down. But remember that even in the case of Joseph, of Moses, of Daniel, and all those other people in the Bible, they went through the difficulties that they went through, but God took them through. God was able to provide David with a Jonathan to get to his destination. God is able to do same even to you today. And so the next question will be, how do you get inspiration and how do you strike the balance between family and service, or what you call ministry? You know, the Bible says it is not by might, it is not by power, but it is by the Spirit of God. Inspiration comes from God. Inspiration comes from maybe watching the news and seeing what is happening and then asking myself, oh, what does the Bible say about this? Or what will the Bible give as solution to this? We also get inspiration, of course, from the Holy Spirit, the still voice speaking to you. We get inspiration through dreams. We get inspiration. I get inspiration sometimes by watching cartoons with my children, by discussing with them, because children know more things than you think that they do. We also get inspiration by discussing with people and seeing what is happening around the world and say, okay, maybe with respect to this situation, this is the solution that the Bible is bringing forth. With respect to how I strike the balance, you know, we have to prioritize in life. Everything revolves around proper planning and setting priorities. There is time for family, which cannot be jeopardized or traded for anything. And there is time for ministry or service, which is also relevant. Sometimes we have to do what we do when the kids are at school or when they are at sleep. Sometimes we have to wait until everywhere is calm before we get to do what we have to do. Sometimes you call me, my phone is on silence because I'm doing one or two things for the Lord. Or you call me and I'm in a position to pick and I'll tell you, I will call you back. So those are some of the things that we are called upon to do. You know, the best place to get inspiration is from the Word of God. When you meditate upon the Word of God day and night, the way Joshua 1, 8 to 9 instructs us, you can be sure that you will get inspiration that is relevant not just for the people you share with, but that is also relevant for you as well, because the Bible cuts back and forth. And so the next question to Mommy Reads on this day when she's celebrating her birthday will be the fact that it will be good for her to tell us about the new book that she has published and where we can find the book. The name or the title of the book is What Went Wrong. And as you can see, it's a picture of a full heart. Then the heart got broken, it was stitched, and then it eventually got bandaged. Oh, plastered. You know, the book is a reflection of who we are in life and in our walk with God. Many of us come to God, we are in love with God, and we are eager to do the things that God wants us to do. And then eventually God blesses us and something happens. You can either get better after the blessing or go downhill after the blessing. And if you go downhill, are you going to remain downhill, or are you going to do the needful to come back up again and continue to cruise at steady speed until you get to heaven, the destination? And so essentially the book recounts the story of you and I, how much we loved God and where we have gotten to at different phases. Are we at the pre-blessing phase? Are we at the blessing phase? Are we at the post-blessing phase? Have we derailed? Are we on track? Are we getting back on track, or are we staying down? But then it is advisable for us to remember that if we forget the first love that we had for God, God will not be happy. And also that if we become lukewarm, God will spit us out. It is advisable for us to get back on track, regardless of how far away we have gone from God, so that God in his infinite mercy will take us back the way he took the prodigal son in Luke chapter 15. Essentially, that is what the book is all about. It's asking us at what phase we are and what went wrong in our love relationship with God. The book is available on Amazon. You can get your copy and also reach out to Mommy Reads if you want a free copy of the soft copy. Mommy Reads is ready to give those who want the free copy, because The objective is to make sure that people get closer to their Bibles, because only the Bible can give us what we need in this world at such a time like this. So that said, the next question to Mommy Reads is the fact that it's your birthday. What will you like as gifts and wishes? That's a good one. First and foremost, I will like or entreat or encourage everybody to pray for Mommy Reads, because we are nothing without prayers. You know, Mommy Reads also needs prayers like every other person out there. And the major prayer point should be that Mommy Reads should end well. Mommy Reads should not start well and end badly. No, she should end well and eventually make heaven. You know, the mistakes that most preachers make is that they usher people into heaven and then usher themselves into hell. But no, we should be the kind of people who pray that even as we pray and encourage others to make heaven, we ourselves should not be shut out. Nevertheless, you can send your wishes, your gifts, that anything that comes from your heart. You can send it through WhatsApp, through Instagram, through Facebook, through PayPal, just anything that the Lord lays in your heart. It can be a sentence, it can be a cash donation, it can be a prayer, it can be anything that the Lord leads you to share with Mommy Reads. Also, the next question will be, where do you see yourself? Let's take this one before the last one. And that is, are you involved in any charity projects? Is Mommy Reads involved in any charity projects? The answer is yes. But unfortunately or fortunately, in this, our little charity projects, we try to do what Matthew chapter 6 instructs us to do, that what the left hand does, the right hand should not know. So we are not very good at broadcasting or calling for paparazzi and propaganda and the camera to come and see what or announce what we are doing. No, we are trying to do what we are doing in a discreet way. But nevertheless, we are open to partners, to sponsors, to kingdom advancement initiatives, to financial initiatives, to reach out to the needy, to reach out to those who are going through difficulties, to reach out to those who have ideas and visions but need capital for startup, because essentially that is where we have been focusing our attention on recently, because we have people who have ideas but then need finances or need funding to kickstart these ideas or see that these ideas become a reality. And so we have been doing that, and by the grace of God, it has been yielding fruit. We've been doing so essentially for women, especially given the crisis and the situations, the challenges that many women go through. By the grace of God, it's been beautiful, and we pray that God will send us more people to chip in one or two things, so their dimes, their initiative, their ideas, their know-how, so that we can reach out to more people. So then the next question will be the fact that where do you see yourself in the next 5 years? Well, that's hard to say, because our future is in God's hands. No matter how tall you are, you cannot see your future. But then we also know that we should not be the kind of people who announce the projects that we have. Let the projects that we have announce themselves. But nevertheless, by the grace of God, if Jesus tarries, we have a book for next year titled The Telephone Call. And we also want to see many more YouTube channels born as a result of the encouragement that came from Meaningful 5 Minutes with Mommy Reads. We already have quite a few, but we will be grateful if this number can increase. So you can reach out to Mommy Reads, as some have already been doing, for vital inputs, vital tidbits on how to start that YouTube channel and do that thing that God has laid in your hands. Also, we organize women's conferences. This 2021 edition is on the 3rd of July, 2021, and we are encouraging everyone to be a part of it. And we are hoping that in the next 5 years, if Jesus tarries, many more people, many more families will be in active service, thanks to what they learned from the life-changing retreat for families that comes up every year, either in June or in July. That is what we think, that if Jesus tarries, we will be able to achieve in the next 5 years? And so the last question as we round up this birthday celebration is the fact that, what is the word of advice? What can Mommy Reed say as word of advice to those who are watching? Well, the truth about it is that you don't have to let anybody discourage you, not even yourself. You know, the watchword of Meaningful 5 Minutes is from 1 Thessalonians 5:11, which says that we should encourage each other as we are already doing. You know, sometimes people are so pessimistic, they always see the glass from the half empty side. You should be the kind of people or the kind of person who encourages yourself in the Lord, regardless of what people are saying or doing or thinking. If you heard from God and you are convinced that you heard from God, don't let anything stop you. Also, don't let your dark today, your bleak today, mar your bright tomorrow. That things are rough today, that things are not yet where they ought to be today, doesn't mean that you should stop. Continue until you see results. Continue until you get to where God has destined you to be. Another thing is the fact that you don't have to wait until you have everything before you start that which you are supposed to start. If you look at Mommy Reed's story so far, when I started the YouTube channel, I did not have all the gadgets that some of us even started with. S1.5, if at all there has ever been an S1.5. I'm not saying that today we have reached S1500. No, all of us are work in progress. We are growing daily. We are learning daily. We are getting to know the little things that we did not know before. We are learning, relearning and unlearning on a daily basis. And so start with the little that you have. After all, the Bible says that whatever your hands find to do, do it well. Be diligent with the little that you have. There was a time I made some videos after the phase of using the computer. Now I switched to the phone. A brother made a comment. He said, wow, very good content, but not so good quality. And I went back to God. I said, God, you see, at least the content is good. It's the quality that is lacking. But the matter, the case file is at your desk. So what am I saying in essence? Don't let the things that you don't have stop you from doing the things that God wants you to do. You can start with the little that you have, and then progressively, you will get to where God wants you to get to. Another thing that we have to do or have to remind ourselves constantly of is the fact that you don't have to depend on man. You don't have to depend on your personal abilities, because the arm of flesh will fail, because man by nature is limited. But we have to look up to God, the author and the finisher of our faith, the one who has called us, because he who has called us is faithful. And last but not the least is the fact that you have to do good to others. This does not mean that when you do good to others, it is the people whom you do good to who will repay you. No. But when you do good to others, the Bible says, give and it will come back to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaking together, running over. It means that you will get much more than what you have given out. It means that you will get bigger and better than what you have given out. Not from the people whom you give, but from God's own storehouse. And so don't stop doing good because people around you are discouraging you, or because circumstances of life are discouraging you, or because you yourself are discouraged. Continue to do the good that you are able to do, because in due season, it will pay off. That was the bits and pieces that we gathered as we celebrate Mommy Reed's birthday today. I hope that this was able to encourage you, that brother, that sister out there, to remember that you don't need it all to get it started. You can start with the little that you have. You should also remember that little is much when God is in it. You should also remember not to despise the days of little beginnings. And so before we go, as we wish ourselves happy birthday, remember that if you've not given your life to Christ, it is advisable to do so. Accept Christ as your Lord and Savior. That is the only guarantee you have on planet Earth to make heaven. Just bow your head and say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. Wash me with the blood of the Lamb. Give me the power to live right. Give me the power to hate sin. Give me the power to walk right before you and to make heaven. And you will be getting it right before it becomes too late. Always remember that the Bible is the road, Jesus the code, sin the obstacle, and heaven the destination. Shalom, good people, and happy birthday to Mommy Reed.